Welcome to Dental Nachos and Dentist Job Connect TV. We have an awesome show for you tonight. You're going to see special guests. You're going to learn how to be a better, a faster, a more efficient, a more confident dentist. We are always giving out bonus guac here, calorie-free bonus guac on Dental Nachos TV. So if you text CROWN to 215-543-6454, text CROWN to 215-543-6454, you will get a free crown prep impression and insert training video from Dr. Michael Frazis from our sponsor, Ripe Global, which is amazing. My team member can also put that into the chat for those of you on Facebook Live. You can also text CROWN to 215-543-6454. So the only reason I am here today is because my dream failed. That dream was to play professional basketball in the NBA. That is Michael Jordan and Charles Barkley on the left. That is me on the right. In high school, I did knock down 43 threes in 16 games, second in the conference. And I know what my dentist people are saying is, we don't believe you, Paul. You probably can't even still make a three. So before we start our show, I want to share that still at this age, I can knock down an NBA length three. If I knock down this NBA length three, all practice owners and DSOs are going to agree to pay their associates some type of income guarantee, because it is totally nacho nuts to expect your associates to work for free. Let's see how it goes. So I showed this to a bunch of dentists last night. You know what they said? How many takes did it take you to make that shot? Because us dentists, we don't believe anyone. We need a CBCT of the CBCT, a bite wing of the bite wing. So before we start our show, I just want to share, if this happens, I am out of Dental Nachos and Dentist Job Connect and practicing dentistry. If they make a senior NBA, I am 100% trying out for that. Don't stop believing. So why did I show that to start our show with sponsor Ripe Global? It is because Ripe Global has created the basketball court you need to practice dentistry. Dentistry is such a difficult thing. It's all in game. You do not get a chance to practice outside your operatory until now. Ripe Global has created an amazing way for you to learn on lifelike models from your own operatory using your own burrs on a time schedule that fits for you. I love going to see courses, speaking and attending, but it is not easy to learn sitting at a table, drinking a cup of coffee from an instructor with verbal instruction. How do you take that back and implement it in your operatory? Ripe Global has created that. Please text FAST to 215-543-6454, where we have some special deals for you throughout this show. So pay attention to the text messages, text FAST to 215-543-6454. So I always say the story is the star in life. Our patients that we transform, hey, their dentures used to fall out at their granddaughter's after party at their recital. We give them implants. Now they snap them in and they're happy. That story is the star. So I want to welcome to Dental Nachos TV, Dr. Yoni Pollack. Dr. Yoni Pollack from Atlanta. He can start his video when he comes up here on the screen. So Dr. Yoni, thanks so much for joining us. You're in Atlanta, Georgia. You're a 2016 dental school grad. Before we talk about Ripe Global, I always love people's story. You're 7 years into this career. I'm a 2002 grad, so that makes me 21 years in. Tell us a little bit about your journey post-dental school.
Well, first of all, can I just say props to those basketball shots?
Thanks.
I think maybe you should have followed your NBA dream. I don't know.
Thanks, Yoni.
You gave up.
Yeah. It was my speed and height. It was just those two things. But, you know,
okay. You leave me only had height growing up. They just told me to stand near the basketball hoop and just keep my arms up at all times. And that was my only skill.
Nice. How tall are you?
Well, I actually, I'm only 5'10", but I used to be 5'10". I was the same height in like middle school.
Oh, wow. So you dominated.
I had a really early
basketball.
So I had an early growth spurt and I just kind of stayed the same since.
There, gotcha.
Yeah, I'm sorry. What was the question?
What did you tell us a little bit about your post dental school life? You know, you graduate from dental school. Did you go right to practice? You do a residency? Do you be an associate somewhere? Tell us about that.
Yeah. So I graduated dental school, and then I was in Brooklyn for about 5 years. I did a residency in Brooklyn, and then I worked as an associate for different dental offices for, 5 years, kind of hopping around here or there. And then, owning a practice was always kind of on the to-do list, and, COVID happened. So it was kind of the kick in the butt to kind of, go to the next phase. So I got tired of paying New York prices for rent and everything. So I found an office here in Atlanta, Georgia, purchased it. And, that was in 2021. So I've been there ever since, obviously, and, putting down my roots and kind of saying, okay, this is where I'm going to be for the remainder of my career. I kind of wanted to really start to invest in my knowledge and my skills. And that's kind of what led me to, Ripe Global.
Oh, awesome. Tell our audience, from associate to owner, what's like the biggest adjustment? I think associates sometimes, I was an associate, we think, I know everything, I was a practice owner, it wouldn't be so hard for me. And then you become a practice owner, kind of say it's going like going from an aunt to a parent, and now the whole thing's yours. What are some adjustments, whether they're business, clinical, team management? Give us an aha moment for our audience watching.
Yeah, I think that was actually really, that's really nail on the head. You're going from an aunt to the parent. I think that's really, I never heard that before, but that's really accurate. So when I was an associate, right, it hit 5 o'clock and I was like, okay, I don't have to care anymore about what happens in this practice. But now that you're an owner, it's 5 o'clock and you're still thinking about it. The weekends, you're still kind of working on it. I'm always kind of thinking about the practice and how I can improve it, how I can improve myself. So that's been kind of, that's
and
been
I would share, as a practice owner, you're the one who has to answer all the questions, right? You are the guy that gets the questions asked to them. From vendors to IT to labs. So I have here Michael Frazes from Ripe, Dr. Michael Frazes from Ripe, who's the director of restorative. People can text in for his free crown prep video. They're going to get some deals. So now walk us through, where'd you hear about Ripe? I think it was through our Nacho World. And, dentists, they don't make decisions quickly. So just walk us through the Ripe experience. You hear about Ripe and you want to be better. What drew you to Ripe? And tell us about that.
Yeah, that's a good, I don't really know how I first heard about Ripe. It was probably somewhere in social media. I think I saw maybe some of Lincoln's posts on Instagram or something. I'm like, man, this guy's really good. I wish I could be like him. And then, I started getting serious about trying to improve my clinical skills. And, there's so many options in terms of what, you can focus on and what kind of courses you can take. But I think what's really nice about, what I'm in is the restorative fellowship. And what's really nice about it is that it's something that you're doing every day pretty consistently. So, I wanted to make sure that the fundamentals, as I'm starting kind of my, long career, I want to make sure that I have the fundamentals down day one. So I'm not spending, 5-10 years struggling, trying to make sure that, trying to improve and get the fundamentals, really down. So everything is becoming consistent and predictable. The things that I'm doing just every day, or even bigger cases, I go into it and I kind of have a, a clear head of what I'm going to do, what I need to do, what are some pitfalls that I can expect? How am I going to address them if they do come up?
I think what you're sharing is it's troubleshooting your technique. You can't do it unless you learn those fundamentals. I help coach basketball, and fundamentals make the game fun. And our fundamentals in dental school, it's just disjointed, right? You don't really get a consistent voice. Now, what made you choose a program like Ripe that you could do this learning from your operatory? How hard was it to get the models together? And you go into your own operatory. You're using your own drills, using your own materials. Walk us through that learning curve. Is it tough to set up? Is it easy to use WebEx? Have you gotten better at photography? Tell us about that.
Oh yeah, photography definitely got a lot better. That's really nice. It really pushes you to become a better photographer and document your work because it is a virtual course, so you can't you don't have an instructor kind of looking over your shoulder, so you do have to focus on your photography skills, which I think is actually a really great skill because you might think in your head, oh, I did such a great job, yada yada yada, but if you look at your photos afterwards, you're like, oh man, I really missed out on this, or I could have improved that. In terms of setting up, it's actually super easy. I just drive to my office. I can get everything set up in maybe about 5, 10 minutes, and then I'm ready to roll. I wouldn't say that's difficult at all. And I'm doing it, I'm using the materials that I'm using in my normal office because I'm in my normal office. So the transition from practicing to doing it for real is there is no transition because
Yeah,
it's the
you have to
same
do it
thing.
the next.
I'm,
That's the whole thing. I mean, I am not someone, I'm surprised it's the Notch audience, but I am terrible at cooking. But if I ever did learn to cook, I
Yeah.
would need my own
Yeah.
stove. I would need to have any chance of implementing it. So tell us, which procedures have you been learning with Rife so far? Crowns, class twos, what tell us
Yeah.
about the actual procedures that you are becoming more efficient with, faster with, better with? Tell us about
Yeah,
that.
so it's been direct and a lot of indirect, restorative. I think the one I'm really wearing right now is actually probably my favorite, and that's really anterior composites, which
Oh, cool.
I've always kind of really struggled with. You can get it done, but is it going to look good? Is it going to look believable? And also, I think dental school does a not a great job teaching you really subtle anatomy and how you design a crown, or how do you design a tooth mentally and then make it physically appear like that. So that's probably been I've been really enjoying that so far. So that's probably been the highlight of my experience so
I like
far.
that. So you've learned both posterior and anterior at this point, or just the anterior so far?
We've done posterior. We're now in the anterior. And then I think we're going to start doing more full mouth rehab after we do the anterior portion. So we're kind of getting in the pieces, and then now we're going to do it as all in one in like a full mouth rehab case. So that's on the horizon.
Awesome. And how to, with your the teaching team from Rife, you interact with them through WebEx. You get to know the other people in your Rife community. Share a little bit about that.
Yeah, that's actually a huge benefit. I don't think it's talked about enough. The educators in Rife are it's funny because there are a couple of educators that I knew about before I signed up. Lane Oakey, Michael Melkers, a couple of others that I knew of, so I knew, okay, this CE, organization has some good educators. There were a couple of other educators that I never heard of, and I thought to myself, oh, okay, this is where Rife cheaps out. They give you some weirdo educators I never heard of before, but actually they're just international, and I kind of looked them up on their socials, and I did a little digging, and they're actually really big where they're teaching as well. So all the educators are really impressive. And like you were saying about the WebEx, which is our kind of our community feature, you can have a lecture by a presenter, and then if you have any issues, you can just direct message them and then
That's
they'll
great.
respond. And they're always very eager to kind of help you if you have any issues. I had a hands-on course the other week, and the educator, we had submitted our assignment, and he's like, if you guys want to practice this, in the future, on your own, and you want some feedback, just please, send me your photos, and I'll be more than glad to, give you
And
feedback
isn't Yoni, what
and
you're sharing, and I'm even coming through your. Isn't that how learning's supposed to be, right? Like, why was our learning so friction-filled in dental school? It was like almost like there was just this tension inside of the learning that was just, I don't know what I would call, oh yeah, totally toxic and not designed to make people better, right? And, I'm not saying every dental school's like that, and I had a great group leader at Penn, but I'm just saying the whole experience of like, and like now you're describing an experience where you have camaraderie, fun, people who have your back, people that you can reach out to, and then you implement this in your dentisting basketball game the next day. And I mean, I just think you should be so proud of yourself for investing in this. You're investing in better patient care, let's, as we wrap up, let's talk about, dentists frequently will look at a patient and say, hey, Janice, that was my patient. It is worth it for you to put $40,000 into dental implants. You are going to be happy that you did this, Janice. And they know Janice is going to be happy. But dentists, when it comes to their own CE, even though they spent hundreds of thousands of dollars in dental school, I don't know what's the word for it. Oh, yes, they're very cheap on their own CE, which is nuts to me because this is what you're doing every day. So what made this investment? Yeah, nacho nuts, exactly. What made this investment? And the investment is more than, I want everyone to understand, because I want Yoni's sharing with us his experience with Rhipe Global, awesome sponsor. The investment of this is more than the money you pay Rhipe Global. When I talk about investment, it's the time you go into your operatory, it's the materials you use. So what makes this total investment from what you've paid Rhipe and your time and your materials worth it for you as a dentist?
Well, I think the biggest benefit is that I know I'm doing right by my patients, which feels great. Knowing that, you know, I did dentistry that probably puts me in the top 10% of, you know, of total clinicians, that my patients are getting, you know, amazing care. And, you know, I just feel, you know, it's just, you know, dentistry can be very anxiety inducing, and just to know that I did a fantastic job and my patients are getting...
I don't believe you. You mean full contact arts and crafts on people that don't want to be there or pay for it. And Charles, you have, it's constant anxiety dentistry. It's constant anxiety. You just have to manage it because you're 6 inches away from someone who doesn't want to be there and they really don't want to pay for it. And they are totally unrealistic of how fast it should take. Right. And you're saying you're doing right by your patients, which is awesome. You're feeling better yourself. And then what I think is important is you're currently a solo practitioner. I'm going to inspire you to hire an associate one day. Dr. Nathan, who was going to be on here, but we have some extra time with you. He said, Rhipe Global has allowed him as a solo practitioner to manage his schedule better, get in more emergencies, which winds up making you help more patients and more productive. So how much impact has it had on your efficiency and productivity?
Well, you know, I would be spending so much time trying to figure out how do I make my dentistry better, but now it's just being taught to me. So I am kind of skipping 5-10 years of struggling. How do I get my dentistry to look like this? And now I'm just doing it. That makes me more efficient. You know, the focus is on quality, but if you're learning from the best of the best and they're teaching you, you know, they've already mastered how to do it well. And once you will master to learn how to do something well, the next step is to master how to do it efficiently. So all those tips and tricks are just being taught to you from these clinical masters. So you're getting to do the dentistry extremely well, but also extremely efficiently. So that obviously helps production. You know, you're doing the best dentistry without compromising by taking longer, which I think is...
And I mean, we have to call it what it is. You have to be, you don't want to rush and not do an acceptable job. And I'm a dentist too. You got a lot of people who need your time each day. So the faster you're able to finish something, the more sane you can be. And that may be hygiene checks. Mm-hmm. That may be emergencies. That may be dealing with an office manager challenge. I think the E-Myth Revisited by Michael Gerber is such a great book because it talks about the dentist as the entrepreneur, the management, and the technician. And when you go into your office, you're there. And what Rhipe Global is doing is it's allowing you to master being the technician in a way that makes you feel better and has more fun. So, I mean, you've really done an outstanding job explaining this. I really appreciate it. Is there anything I missed about the program that if someone was watching on Zoom, watching on Facebook, listening in their car, on the recording that you should bring to light about the program, whether it's time, cost, commitment, anything else?
Yeah. Sign up yesterday. Get going. You'll thank yourself. This is just a really, really good way. The best way. I mean, I'm in other CE as well, but Rhipe Global is definitely by far so different and so much, you know, head and shoulders above the rest. You know, you're going to learn from the best. I mean, it's like taking courses from all these different educators in one CE. So it's, I mean, I don't know what else offers that. And you have a great community.
Call it truly nacho-tastic. And well, you said something with the sign up yesterday, and that's why I want to bring this out. Dr. Brett Burris, who I think is a little further along than you in his career, but younger than me, I talk about ROI is return on investment. That's money. It's also relationships, opportunity, impact. And Brett said, I wish I could have gotten this ROI earlier in my career. You know, he is a PPO dentist doing full mouth rehabs now. Sounds like you're going to be on this similar track. And I just think it unlocks a world that you didn't know existed and creates what Dental Nachos talked about. And you always be collaborating, always be connecting. You've shared so much here. If someone wanted to reach out to you directly, ask you a question, check out your practice website, what would be the best way for them to do that?
Yeah, I say you could find me on Instagram. You could find me on Facebook. I'm open to any questions. If you want to talk anything, if they want to talk basketball, they should probably talk to you. But if they want to talk about anything else or having other questions about Ripe Global, you know, just shoot me a message. And I'm here.
What's your Instagram handle?
It's Y Pollock, you know, my last name, and then my degree, which is DMD.
Awesome.
I'm cooler than the DDSs.
Yeah, I'm DMD too. Go into the chat and put.
Yeah, there you go.
Text Morgan your t-shirt size and address. We'll send you some nacho swag, which is great for the gym and formal events. Okay. So thanks, Yoni, for being on. I know you had a long day. I so appreciate it. Quite grateful for what you're doing.
All right. So take care, guys.
Thank awesome, you. Yoni. We're now going to move into our next segment. That was an amazing share from Dr. Yoni. If you're just chiming in, you missed me shooting 3-point shots in the beginning, but we can get you this recording. I want to remind you before I turn this over to Ripe, I'll still be on, to text Crown to 215-543-6454. You will get a free Crown Prep training video from the awesome Dr. Michael Frazes. So I am going to stop share, and I'm going to let the Ripe team share their screen. We have people here on Zoom. We have people here on Facebook Live. Please feel free to ask questions in the Q&A. So our Ripe Global team, we have Matt from Ripe Global. And now I don't have any of those like Austin Power things, but now we're going to go. It is right now, Matt. It is December 6, 2023. But we are going to go back 20 years back to 2003. And Dental Nachos did not exist. Should take off the sweatshirt. Dennis Job Connect did not exist, but I existed, Matt. And I was a dentist.
No iPhone.
We had a Nokia.
No emails.
A text would take you 15 minutes, right? So 2003, this is Dr. Paul Goodman, graduated from Penn. I did a one-year GPR at Albert Einstein. And when you call into Ripe Global, and my team member will put in the chat how you can call in and get the best deal possible through Dental Nachos. Cam is going to be on later with an extra special deal. Matt, you do the consults with people like me. So I am 2003 grad. I have called into Ripe Global and I am ready for my consult. I heard about this program through Dental Nachos. I am 2003, Dr. Paul. I'm ready for you.
Yeah, so lovely to meet you, Paul. And, as a recent graduate, would you be able to just give me a bit of an idea of the practice that you've joined as a recent graduate, the dentists around you, and what that practice looks like and how you're feeling in that practice right now?
Awesome. I love that question. So I joined my father and his partner in practice, which is amazing because I have two dentists that have my back at all times. But it also creates anxiety, Matt, because I'm treating my third grade gym teacher from when I was a kid. So it is a family practice. And one of the things I can share about a family practice is the patients sometimes have unrealistic expectations of the new kid dentist son on the block. I went to Penn and my dental school was light on clinical reps. Okay. It was a good school for academics. I did have a good restorative treatment planning, training, but we didn't do a ton of extractions. We did not do a ton of endo. We did not get a lot of specialty training. So I did a GPR at Albert Einstein, which was an amazing experience, Matt. I got to extract hundreds of teeth. I got to put jaws back together. I got to fix people if they were punched in the face. So I got to do all these cool things. But now that I am in the town of New Jersey, I do not feel confident in my efficiency and my restorative dentistry. Crowns, multiple fillings. I wish I was faster. I wish I was like the other dentists in the practice.
Yeah, Paul, look, we talk to many, many dentists like you every day. And Your story is very, very common, and you should feel excited about the journey that you take in your practice. And we'll also just make a note that we're really interested. My colleague Cam is going to talk to what we can do in the whole practice as we progress into this conversation. But, you know, as a graduate dentist, we work with many of your type, and we take you on a fast track journey to really build out your confidence and skill set. So from a right perspective, we really look at what we can do in terms of our method. And what we'll do initially with you, Paul, is we'll do an assessment. We'll get a feeling where you're at in benchmarking in terms of where you're at across the broad sector of dentistry from graduate through to mastery. We're going to deliver you theory. We're going to do a lot of work in simulation. So we're going to talk to that very shortly, but that simulation work is going to be incredibly important to build your confidence and skill sets up to be able to deliver the dentistry in mouth. We're then going to transfer that into the practice. So we're going to do a lot of work in terms of supporting you to do these procedures and workflows in practice. We're going to do case presentations with you to demonstrate that you've learned the skills and you're delivering those skills to a clinical excellence. We're then going to focus on quality and speed. We'll measure and then we'll continue the process throughout the training with different methodology, with different workflows in terms of ortho, implantology, perio, and other parts of specialties in dentistry.
Great.
So fundamentally, Wright Global, we're going to focus, before we even think about what we're going to do in terms of a speciality and restorative, all of our students are going to learn incredible treatment planning skills, incredible patient communication skills, and focus on dental photography. We're a photocentric organization. So for us, your dental photography is just the most important thing we can focus on. When we dive into restorative, crown prep, quadrants, restorative, we're going to be restorations. We're going to deep dive into all of these elements to get you to an incredible place. Now,
cool. Great.
One of the things we're going to do is we're going to ship you a simulation unit. So you can see our sim head in the middle here. We have some models. We've got our restorative models, and we have some specialty models for some of our other courses. And we're going to ask you to bolt that into a chair, and we're going to do our simulation work on that. It's something that's very unique to Wright Global, and it's going to give you incredible ability to get uplift in clinical performance in your surgery as you progress through these workflows. Does that awesome. Kind of make sense to you so far?
Yeah, I mean, I as somebody who has a, sometimes you get tough flashbacks of looking at Typonaut models from your dental school days, but I think it's really cool that if you incorporate this into your own operatory, I always had struggled on the weird things they put us on in dental school. So I think it's great. I can use my own chair for this.
Yeah, so very, very different methodology to dental school, because as you can see, we're going to focus in on doing high repetitions. We're going to focus in on making you go fast in a simulation mode so that you can really fine tune and make the mistakes in simulation mode before we transfer those skill sets to the patient. So you can see here, we've got our workflow that we're going to use in simulation. You're going to be a dentist in your own surgery doing this work, which really allows you to fine tune your skill sets and using the materials that you have available to you. Now, as a graduate dentist, I'm sure your dad's already made the decision what composite you're going to use and what ceramics you're going to use and all those elements. And this is going to allow you to fine tune those skills. And we're going to give you feedback on that using clinical photography. We're going to take a lot of photos, and we're going to give you feedback on your prep style. So that might be occlusion, taper, undercuts, margin, interproximal integrity, all drawn out for you, communicated back to you quickly. And then we're going to allow you to free up your mental bandwidth to do quite a lot of this work as we progress. I'll just show you a couple of photos, yeah? So you can see here a dentist doing work in the class environment, so no need to travel to a
Are the other people on the screen, are those their classmates, or are those the people teaching?
Yeah, so they're going to be your peers, Paul. These These are dentists that are going to work with you around the world. In the USA, you'll be working with dentists in the US, EU, and also Canada. You'll become incredibly close with these people. They're going to be your buddies as you progress through the program. You're going to see their stuff. They're going to see your stuff. And you're going to, these are going to become lifelong friends.
Awesome.
So the simulation model really allows us to get deep into what we're doing, allow us to really practice out those skills and fine tune as we progress. And what we're really here to discuss, Paul, is, you know, from your perspective as a grad dentist heading into a practice, restorative is going to be the backbone of what you need over the next 5 to 10 years. And we're going to help you fast track that program. I'm just going to talk to this program quickly if you're happy to hear some details on our restorative program.
Sounds great.
Awesome. So our restorative program will do 44 lectures. We'll do 7 pre-theory challenges where we'll ask you to do some casework on our simulation unit before we get into the case presentation. We'll do 8 simulation sessions over a 2-year period. We can do those simulation sessions in 6 months to give you a big uplift in fast track performance. So we can do those in sequence over a 2-year period. We've got 17 case presentations that we're going to need you to do in both direct and indirect to show and demonstrate that you've learned the skills and also to give you uplift in performance as you progress through these cases. And then you're going to have that mentor space that Jan spoke about just before, in terms of being able to connect with mentors and get feedback on cases as you sort of progress through that aren't necessarily part of case presentation, but cases that you'd like support on, or you're proud of, or you've progressed into, and you've got complications that you need to look at.
Really cool. I think it's great that you can ask other dentists in your cohort. You know, the dentists in your office can be great mentors too, but you know, there's a certain emotional entanglement at times when you're asking people in your own office. I think it's great that you can go to mentors online who are there to just support you, and they're not part of your everyday practice life, Matt, but also can just kind of give you that objective, supportive feedback.
I feel, Paul, like we could deep dive into your experience of asking your father for mentoring and working on challenging cases, but we certainly find that all of the dentists use that space and get a massive amount of uplift and support from that, and it becomes so ingrained in what they do, and really the core of what we do is based in that community and support.
Yeah, I think that's
structure.
Awesome.
Yeah. So before we jump into the real, real nitty gritty detail of what we're going to do in posterior, this is what we found with the students that we've put through. We find that we'll increase case acceptance by up to 2.5 across from where you are now into the future. And that really comes down to both the skills we're going to teach you in clinical photography and treatment planning, the uplift in confidence we're going to give you, and also the disciplines we're going to teach you to be able to do this consistently. We're going to see a treatment plan size increase by 4, and that's by looking at the mouth more holistically and really understanding what the patients would like in their mouths and what the opportunity is there, and then giving you the clinical skills to deliver that. We're going to focus on procedure speed. Now, this is not going to be at the detriment of clinical excellence. We're focused on clinical excellence, but to produce clinical excellence, particularly as we move into anterior and full mouth rehab procedures, we really need to get you to a point where you can do this dentistry in a really fast and efficient manner whilst being clinically excellent. Yeah?
Totally get
that. Does that sound good to you, Paul?
All that sounds great. Sounds like you're going to be able to help more patients, make more money, and not have to work more. That is the, because dental hours matter, dog ear hours. It's being at the chair for an hour is a lot of, I call it intensity. So anything you can do to create a better patient experience, do more work on people that's needed, be more productive, and have more fun, I'm all on board for.
Awesome. We're going to love having you as a student, Paul. The big thing, The byproduct of all this is your production, hourly production rate's going to go up consistently. And that's really going to give you the tools to allow you to move forward and pay back some student debt and buy a house and new car and a holiday and all those things. But it's really a byproduct of these other elements that we've focused on. Yeah.
Awesome.
Cool. So just quickly, we're going to fly through this quickly. When we jump in and our methodology, I just went slides catch up. The big thing for us, the really, really big thing for us is to make you efficient, clinically excellent at delivering 20-minute crown preps. This is a building block, a foundational skill set that will help support you as you progress through your career. So I don't know where you're at with your crown preps right now, Paul.
Mine's probably three times as long. I mean, you know, most a new dentist like me, when it comes down to it, are scheduling probably 2 hours for an entire crown procedure, and the dentist in the office are scheduling 50 to 75% of that time. Also, having to check hygiene patients adds to the whole time too. So anything I could do to make it more efficient will make everybody happier in the office, especially my dental assistant. They'll be happier too.
Yeah, that's awesome. And fundamentally, we're going to give you mental bandwidth back so that then you can start progressing into quadrant dentistry. And you know, we'll focus on some quadrant composite work. And then as we progress through it, anterior work, but without that foundational ability to do fast, efficient crown preps, we can't move into this. So as we progress through, we're going to look at an indirect anterior crown preps, provisionals. We're going to get you to a point where you can get predictable, incredible outcomes fast. And we're going to teach you shape, color, morphology, cant, texture, light, photography, all those elements into the interior side of things to give you a really incredible foundation to be able to deliver these to patients. And from that perspective, that's going to wrap up your first year with us. If we're in the sequence program, we'll do it a little bit quicker and fast track. Then we're going to jump into veneers. Cool. Yeah, this is cool. This is where it all starts. So ceramic veneers, getting you incredible outcomes, predictable outcomes, really getting you to the point that you can deliver this predictably with your patients, so you're really confident about these skill sets. We'll then back that up with composite veneers. So once again, delivering shape, color, doing mock-ups, getting incredible mock-ups together to get the treatment plan acceptance across the line. And then what we'll end up with is the ability to move into full mouth rehab. And when we get into here, we're going to really dive into bruxism and occlusal planes and vertical dimension lifts and different types of materials. And we have such an incredible cohort of mentors that are specialists in doing full mouth rehab. So we're going to be able to get you that skill set and make you really confident and happy doing these types of cases.
Awesome. That's great.
Cool. So, you know, that's our fellowship in restorative dentistry. This particular case here, just talk to this case quickly. This was a dentist that joined us a number of years ago. She's a dentist that was feeling really, really apprehensive and scared about doing crown preps. And over the course of the period of time she spent with us, she went from not wanting to do crown preps at all the way through to making beautiful crowns in simulation mode. You can see her full mouth rehab simulation mode here on the right-hand side, and then being able to transfer that into full mouth rehab in the patient's mouth, these beautiful crown preps, a really nice, time-efficient, non-stressful way for her. And that supported that she's now, you know, a really high-functioning dentist and having a great time in dentistry because she did the course. Just a couple of notes. We do have, in addition to restorative, we've got a new grad program focusing on posterior. We've got the Align Orthodontic program and an implantation course in implantology. And I'll throw to Ken in a second on this one. But before we wrap up, did you have any more questions on the fellowship side of things, our methodology?
Maybe it's coming, but what's the investment that I would be making? What's the cost I would be making? What would be the cost to me as the new dentist looking to figure out how to make this work financially for myself?
Yeah, so I'll just flick to this slide here, which will answer this question. Our list price for a full fellowship is the $20,773 USD dollar Mark, and we have some incredible incentives happening with you here through
Gentle Nuts. Take a screenshot of this if you're from my team. This is a truly amazing offer. I mean, this the retail price is super reasonable, Matt, but you get this. My grandmother's right. I am very special. I was able to kindly annoy Cam. I'm a very, very cheap dentist. I'm a very good negotiator. So I told him we need our best price for the dental nachos. We're good dentists. We also like a deal. So this is the course that Yoni was talking about. MSRP is the $20,773, but please take a screenshot of this. Please grab that QR code. And basically they just need to book a time and make that call happen and sign up before the end of the year, and they will be able to take advantage of this. They do the call in the next 48 hours and then commit before the end of the year.
Absolutely, Paul. And what I would say is there's a huge saving in not needing to travel and accommodation and time away from family. So from that perspective, we're really well priced to begin with, but we're really keen to partner and have support our Dental Nachos partnership. So we've got this great offer, and I think Cam's going to speak just quickly on this, and then from there we'll jump into Cam stuff. Did you have something to say? Wanted to add to it, Cam?
Firstly, I think it's been really great to hear from one of our amazing students. That's brilliant, Paul. Thanks for organising that. Always inspirational, Paul, for you to be on here. You are, I don't like to use the word cheap. I'm still struggling with you as a 2003 okay. dentist. Yeah. You know, like it's a bit dusty around here. But look, for the audience that's out there, amazing partnership with our Dental Nachos friend. And I don't know whether you've ever spent time with Paul, but like he's really convincing. Like it doesn't convince a little bit, but like his treatment plan acceptance rate would have to be 100%. I don't think there's even a measure that's not. So Paul treatment planned me about closing out a deal for Christmas, or do you call it happy holidays over there, but whatever it is. And so I think $1,500, so that's if you just book a call by the end. You don't have to have had the call by Friday. That might be a bit tricky with your schedules.
Okay.
But if you get on a call pre-Christmas and take advantage of one of the Dental Nachos deals, then we'll take $1,500 minimum off any course. But you're a hard man, Paul.
I know.
And
we want more.
Work with you. And I know. I get it. And so with some of the other things we're doing with sponsorship and et cetera, on this course, my team will kill me because I haven't got approval from them, but we're going to knock $5,000 off this course.
Oh, that's awesome.
If you schedule it before Christmas, and it's Dental Nachos, Paul Goodman's special Christmas bonus, all right?
And I love this.
Yeah,
I don't
our
know how
educators
Australian...
have come together, and I've had to negotiate with a bunch of people just so we make that happen. But if Dental Nachos community want to get into it, you save that $5,000 for a fully paid program.
We truly appreciate that, Cam. And I am a kindly annoying person, you know. Dentists do like to save on taxes. Many of them can, you know, commit this in 2023 before the end of the year and then be like Dr. Yoni. I think, you know, what we're sharing, we're going to talk to you, Cam, more about a few other things before we wrap up. But what he said was so key. Sign up yesterday. And the reason he's saying that is not to primarily help me or Ripe Global, but it's to help the dentist listening thinking, I need to feel more confident. When I walk into that operatory, I have more anxiety than is necessary. Dental school, let's just say what it is, may have let me down. And now I am an associate dentist, a new practice owner, growing practices, and get better inside of that operatory. So I love this offer, Cam. My team will get this to everybody who's watching in here, but book your call. Just hold your phone up to the QR code. My team member, Morgan, will put it in Facebook Live in the chat. Truly appreciate that, Cam. I'm 1,000% treatment plan acceptance for getting Ripe Global to give us great deals. So,
yeah. And look, one last thing, Paul, is if there's any dental group owners on the call, just booking a call directly with Matt, myself, or Jason. Jason's on the call. He's keeping quiet because he's got to work out how to pay for the discounts that I just gave away. If there's dental group owners, get on a call. We're doing amazing things with dental group owners. where we create camaraderie and teamwork. And look, I've got principals that are coming onto the program. You at some in your community, Paul, as well, where with their team, they're transforming, you know, the optimal treatments for all of their patients all at one time, led from the top. And, you know, that's amazing. So if you want to do a deal on multiples, I'm not sure how much more than $5,000 we can do, but certainly just reach out, book a call with me personally, and I'm more than happy to see what we can do to help your doctors, you know, basically the best dentistry they possibly can, both now and into the future, you know?
Awesome, Cam. I want to spend a few minutes with you over the time. I just want to ask you a couple questions. Matt, awesome job talking to 2003 Paul. But what 2003 Paul did was he went and invested in Facebook. So he's retired from dentistry. So I bought Facebook back in, you know, right when it came out. So I'm now retired on an island. But thanks so much, Matt. I appreciate your time.
Thanks, Paul. Look forward to chatting. Welcome to the cohort.
Awesome. Can't wait to come to the US to see us. So I just want to catch everybody up because some people are listening to this on demand. And we have talked with Dr. Yoni Pollack, who is a practice owner who's taken Right Global, said sign up yesterday. What he said, Cam, I think hopefully made you proud, was he knows he's doing right by patients. He didn't say first, I'm producing $4,000 an hour. He didn't say I'm able to work three columns. He said he feels like he's in the top 10% of dentists doing right by patients. And Lincoln Harris, my good friend, Cam, your whole team, the Artie Volkers, the Michael Frazises, the people teaching should feel so proud that you make someone in Atlanta, Georgia feel that way from Australia. So I don't think as a little kid you were thinking you'd be here in this moment. So how does that make you feel, Cam, as one of the co-founders?
Yeah, look, and so you know that I'm an accidental non-dentist, Paul. You know, my career's been in technology and helping organizations do amazing things and individuals at scale. And so dentistry is not my background, but what I love is helping people become better. And the proudest moments in my life historically is when you can coach and mentor a human being to then go on to have a really successful career, not by focusing on money, but becoming more valuable. And so outside of dentistry, we talk about, you know, if you want to be top of industry and making a difference, fundamentally at your core, irrespective of industry, you've got to become more valuable, because in life, people who are valuable end up being more successful. And the you know, one of the scorecards of that is money. But the other is that you leave a legacy of people around you where you've done amazing things. Yeah. And so when I hear a student on the call earlier who's really talking about him becoming more valuable, and the exchange of financial return by being more valuable and doing great things for patients, I mean, that is the answer. And that sort of defined my career prior to being involved in dentistry. And the thing that I couldn't be more proud of the team, but also the community, which you know, we're talking about building valuable outcomes for patients and our communities and where dentistry is going. And by becoming more valuable as clinicians, they have been getting the rewards they deserve because they actually have earned the right to be more successful because of the great work they do. And, you know, it's not all about money, as you know, but what we know is if you consistently do the right thing in the right way and you get better and better out of it, your returns come. And that's both in satisfaction and financial return. So you never regret doing the right thing. And helping craft that community with you and you know, our partners is amazing.
I love that, Cam. Now, actually, let's talk with 2023 distinguished bearded Paul Goodman. So now this Paul Goodman owns two dental practices, and I have two general dental associates working with me. One is, you know, like a 2016 grad. One is a 2021 grad. And then they're surrounded by all these high-level dentists, and it can't be easy. So we want to help them as practice owners. I know you're working with Dr. Kyle Green and the REM team. We talk with Rodeo Dental. So whether you own two practices like me, 10 practices like the REM team, okay, 8 practices, 50 practices like Rodeo Dental, how is Right Global helping teams, you know, like us, help their associates feel more confident? We have Dr. Yoni, story of one. I hope he hires an associate, but now just talk to me, because you do a lot of work with this, about how group practice owners can connect with Right for this.
Yeah, one of the learnings I've had, Paul, coming from non-dental background, is that, you know, historically organisations of, you know, 5, 10, 20, 100, 1,000 people have really good support programs for people who specialise in doing things within organisations, but they don't go to the CEO to ask to get coaching and help for everything they do. And if you look at dentistry, your principal dentist or your leaders, they're like CEOs in any other organization. They're like the amazing people who have made it. They're successful, and their skill levels is often quite intimidating. And you learn better by having programs around you where people that are not your boss is the one coaching you.
Yes.
Yeah. And the second thing that we know is that, you know, you can't actually learn anything unless you can benchmark and understand where an individual's at or a group of individuals is at. And for every individual clinician out there, the most amazing way to make your dentistry better that I see is actually starting with incredible clinical photography, because photos don't lie about the quality of each individual procedure. They literally tell the truth of exactly what it is you do.
Cam, while you were talking, I want to just add to this, that you maybe, because you said it's often better to learn by someone who's not your boss, right? It's why parents probably don't teach piano lessons as well as piano teachers. There's an emotional component. But the other thing I want to share, and maybe bringing back to my amazing dad, you know, sadly passed away in 2016. We were working sometimes, Cam, 10 feet from each other, but he wouldn't watch my patients over my shoulder because it wasn't appropriate. So what's kind of wild is, in the game of dentistry, it's not really appropriate for the CEO, principal dentist, to walk in and look over someone's shoulder while they are doing work and charging patients. But from what Dr. Yoni's shared, your teaching team is literally doing that on WebEx. So these associates are having masters look over their shoulder in the moment. And my thought is that that just creates tremendous confidence in that younger associate.
Yeah, so Dr. Link Harris, yeah, you'd reckon being mentored one-on-one by him would be awesome, yeah?
Yeah, yes.
Yep, like the people who die for it. So,
yes.
You know, Link, an incredible clinician. You guys have known each other for years. You know, I'm intimidated by your dental skill set. as a little anecdote, one of Lincoln's clinicians who was not performing well but mentored by Lincoln, but was still only doing sort of $30,000 a month and was questionable in terms of their contribution to dentistry. And most people on this call would go, $30,000 a month, you've been out for 7 or 8 years, is on a low side.
Yeah.
And Lincoln put this particular individual, Ekaterina, into our Ripe Global restorative program. And a year and a half later, I was chatting the other day. In fact, I run the numbers on the clinic. She currently does $1,275 average per hour productive billings. Loves it. She's an English second language, comes from Russia, works in Bundaberg. So even working for Lincoln, who's one of the best clinical mentors you can meet, but within the clinic, didn't work.
It's the emotional entanglement between you and the person teaching you.
It's too complicated.
Yeah, you know, people say it was great to have my dad as a mentor. I bet you, thinking back, I was embarrassed to tell him stuff, and I probably tried to figure it out by not telling him, where I might have even told someone who wasn't my dad. So I totally get that. So this was Lincoln's own associate who went through the program, but was able to get some training from non-Lincoln face, right? Other faces.
Yeah.
And has transformed her whole career over it.
Transformed. And I mean, we've got multiple of those. I mean, Lincoln's got 3 people in the clinic at the moment, all in our programs, and they're all going, one's sort of going from 300 to 600, 700 an hour average billings. Another one's gone from, you know, 250, 300 to 500, 600, 700. And then we've got one that's gone from, you know, 300 to 1200, 1300 over that period of time. So, you know, the worst person to mentor a dentist is the incredible dentist who can no longer remember what it was like to be a bad dentist.
I couldn't not agree with you more. Well, you guys have shared so much value here, Cam. I appreciate these amazing deals. I just want to wrap up by telling people that Ripe Global, I'm honored to have you as a partner. We're making dentistry better together. I say almost multiple times a day to people that I meet that Ripe Global has invented the thing that dentistry has needed for years. dental school is letting down the profession as a whole. I know there are some amazing ones, but I spoke to a grad recently, Cam, that did not do a crown prep start to finish on the same patient and is now out in the real world. And you guys are filling in these gaps. So please, huge gratitude for me at Dental Nachos. I'm going to take us off Facebook Live. We'll hang here on Zoom for a minute. But thank you so much for sharing with us tonight.
It's been a pleasure, Paul. And yeah, as we lead into Christmas, I hope the billings go well. Procedures are awesome. And we get ready for some happy holidays.